going on, guys? We're here again, DC5 Chance in the building. We're about to unbox the stage 2 Yanakas. How do you say Yanakas?
Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stage 2 Yanaka drive shaft for the RSX.
This way.
It was the right way. You had it the right way.
I was told it was wrong.
Yeah, here's the stage 2 premium drive shafts. These are the old stock ones that we're not reusing. We're gonna have to separate the passenger side one from the half shaft, which is gonna be an ordeal. As you can see, we popped this one out trying to separate the whole axle, so we just ended up taking the whole thing from the transmission. Here we go, packing peanuts. You're gonna have to clean those up, you know.
Damn, I had it backwards. Never mind.
You got a sticker. Hey, you got two stickers.
Hey, sticker.
Two stickers. There's one on the side there.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, a white shit. One white and a black one. That's tough.
Bro!
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so these are supposed to be hardened and better, I guess, the bearings and stuff in the inside are all better for, better rated for torque and horsepower, basically.
Don't need that.
Yeah, that Spider-Man movie was actually hard, though.
Oh, yeah?
Super fun.
So that's how that's supposed to come out. That's the passenger side.
I don't know, feel kind of the same.
Definitely the stage 2s look better.
Oh yeah.
Looks stronger. Yeah. Better made.
No, they definitely do.
One next to the other.
On top of that, they're clean.
So this is the passenger side, which we'll have to put in the and that's the driver's side. So, yeah, those are the
these are clean.
Stage 2s. Once again. Can't wait to get these in. And
no, this one's
blow up the transmission.
Alright.
Now we can't break drive shafts, so we're just gonna blow the transmission.
Hey. At least we know we're gonna be able to drive.
Yeah.
At least we know we're gonna be able to drive now.
Yeah. It's all good.
At least I'll drive straight.
Alright, so I was able to get the passenger side axle off after using the hammer and these chisels to beat the crap out of it and separate it off the half shaft. Now we can basically install the new axle and the half shaft. We're going to install the half shaft and the transmission, then put the passenger side axle in, and then the driver's side axle and connect them to the hubs last. That way we can avoid this happening again. So yeah. Alright, so next thing is apply Honda Bond to the drain pan and reinstall it after we drill the hole. We can clean it one more time because it got some stuff in it, but we'll clean it one more time, then install it, and then we'll be set to go. But yeah. It's the day after Christmas. I want to wish everybody
Merry Chrysler.
A Merry Chrysler. And a happy holidays for whatever you celebrate. As you can see, the PLM mounts have arrived. Came looking pretty good. There's some hardware, I guess, in here. And basically, these are the mounts that we needed to reinstall the tranny back into the engine. So, yeah. We're just going to install the ones that we have and basically get to fitting the transmission back into the engine bay, bolting everything back up, putting the crossmember subframe back in, putting the axles in, then putting the subframe back in, And then we're getting close with the turbo stuff. Basically everything drivetrain wise will be complete. Then it'll be the fuel system and vacuum and plumbing for the turbo, basically. That's that. Oh yeah, yeah. Joe, we spent a day heat taping the exhaust manifold and it came out pretty decent.
We're pretty happy with it. Yeah. Came out clean.
Got it to where it's presentable for Josh at least to pop the hood. You know the vibes. So yeah. We're gonna clean that up. And well, it's clean, but we're gonna mount that up later in the video. So yeah. That's that. What's going on, everybody? Happy New Year. It is cloudy and cold on this Monday morning. I think it's the 3rd. We're here with the cars. Not much has changed. Well, a little bit has changed. So I did end up picking up my M66 all-wheel drive tranny. The manual transfer, the Volvo is here. I have a few things as far as mounting it and getting it wired up for the swap from automatic, but the transmission is here. See it there with the throw-up bearing. I have a problem there with the collar gear. I'll talk about it later in another video, probably. The shifter cables I'm gonna have to work on, but I just wanted to show you guys that the manual tranual has arrived, and we're getting moving on the Volvo. As far as Manny's car, the tranny's back in, clutch is mounted, the shifter cables are mounted. We're just basically ready to put the cross member back in and do the exhaust and get it ready for basically turbo stuff. What I did want to talk to you guys about, or what I was alarmed about, was when we reinstalled the clutch. This was a used clutch, and a used Action Stage 3 clutch. But when you push the clutch down, like all of this is just free play, like nothing's happening here. And then you get to where it's tight, like here, and then the clutch is here. So it's kind of weird. I mean, it might be what a Stage 3 is supposed to feel like. I don't know. But you guys let me know in the comments, because this is all play. And then the clutch engages like here. And it's kind of hard to push. But I mean, like, it's cool if that's what it's supposed to be. I just want to know. So if you guys could confirm, that would be cool. And then everything else is pretty much the same. It's going in the gear fine. All that is good. The manifold is wrapped. And yeah, we have this for the turbo drain and other things. So yeah. As far as, but what you guys are really here for, can't show it yet. What you're really here for today, we're introducing a Tim's new car to the channel. You want to let them know what you got, yo? Or should I just show them? Or should I just show them?
Nah, you can show them first.
All right. Here it is, yo. It's Tim's new IS300 to 2002. It's not much to know. You can see it's wide body. Got wheels. Set of wheels on it. I'm gonna pop the hood. It's pretty much stock. It's a GE motor. This car is auto and it's a GE, but both of those probably will be changing. Maybe GET, maybe 3SGE.
3SGTE.
GTE swapping this. I don't know, we don't know. But it's definitely gonna be a manual eventually, and we'll be doing an LSD. Did come with some cool lights and stickers and stuff. We added some other stickers to it. And yeah, it's slowly.
Cold start?
Yeah, it's in. Here's your cold start. So yeah, it's got a little bit of the cat back exhaust. There's an exhaust leak up here.
front bumper,
headlight on that side. The hood needs cleaning. It needs some things, but other than that, it's a pretty clean car. It's got new rear tail lights. Yeah, so it looks pretty good. Oh, the hood spoiler light came on. That's sick. We're gonna let her warm up, and then we have a box to drop off, so we're gonna get some clips, some driving clips, some peeling off clips, you know the vibes. So yeah.
O2 with manual shifting modes.
It's an auto, but it's got manual shifting.
Yeah, it's got little paddles and shit.
It is 20 degrees out right now, but like the temp gauge would not get over like the fourth nick. Like, yeah, that's as hot as it got, and we drove it for like what,
half hour.
And usually it gets to like halfway, but I mean, it is cold outside, but
it's like freezing literally.
But we might have to check that sensor, the temperature sensor, because she wasn't blowing any heat. Yeah. But other than that, that is the new car. This is the Gangsta Garage 2JZ IS300. For now, it's a 2JZ. We, like I said, maybe a 3S GTE. Maybe boosting the shit out of this. Maybe a 2JZ GTE. So, but yeah, big plans for this. Definitely going to be sliding it. You're going to see a lot of stuff for content on this IS300. Again, I need you guys to let me know about that. If any of you guys has an Action Stage 3 clutch, let me know how your pedal feels. I need to know that, so comment down below. And yeah, so I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. I'll probably be working on this or that, so yeah. It's cold, I'm gonna get back inside. Peace. Think about, and she fuck with me because I am the one that still come back even though I made it out. I thought she was G when I put in my D, she was screaming, she said come on take it out. And all you see, I swear that's everything, and for me got niggas that gon' kill it out. And when I do a show, it's 100,000 with the video, probably he's just paying out. And she know he a bum, so his girlfriend with me, and you know at late night she be staying out. Doing all that, my bad, I didn't mean that, but she was saying, hey, you know, we got a big girl, that's all on my hands, and that's probably the reason I'm out here be racing out. I'm too evil, too evil, too evil, too evil, this divide, I'm in the same. I remember when I was hungry, my girl, I answered my phone, I listened to Tiki, my diamonds, they dance like this round, look at my wrist, it's lit now.